Jesus. Jesus. Glory to God. Get ready. No. Everyone stand up.
All right.
Glory be to God. And put your hands together for our powerful man, the great man of the house, Major Kimball.
Praise God, everyone. Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Come on, give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Listen, I'm nobody. He's somebody. He's the one. Amen. Let's give him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You may be seated, saints of God. Amen. Before I come, amen, I asked one of the sisters of the church, amen. I pull on her and the sister quite a bit. Amen. I'm going to ask Sister Yaz if she come and give us a solo.
Amen.
Give a hand praise as she come.
Amen. Amen. Come on,
God is up to something. Signs and wonders taking place in this place. Father, I thank you for a rhema word that will bring conviction to our lives, that we'll never be the same. Father, I thank you for restoration. I thank you for healing. I thank you for reconciliation. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for causing us to rise above every situation. In Jesus' name, you are the lifter of our head, oh God. You are joy in a time of sorrow. You are peace in the midst of the storm. Hallelujah, God. You are strong deliverer. And we cry out to your holy name. We love you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. We magnify you, Jesus. We say, have your way in this place right now. We thank you, Lord God. Now let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O God, our Lord, our Redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. We give God praise today. Give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We give honor to God, who is the head of our lives, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, who is God. Amen. Our comfort and keeper. Amen. We honor Elder Mitchell and Lady Mitchell. Amen. Glory to God. We honor the first lady of this house, Lady Campbell. Amen. My lovely wife. We honor all the saints of God in the house. Hallelujah. We thank the Lord for the presence of the Holy Spirit in the place. Hallelujah. There is a word from the Lord. Amen. I want to encourage you. Amen. Saints of God, when I say give yourself to God, I make a plea to you this very day. This is not the time to be wayward. This is not the time to be caught up. This is the time to be wholehearted, devoted to God. Amen. Amen. Satan is doing everything he can to try to throw you off course, to try to bring division in the house, to try to have family, try to have church. Amen. To get you to doubt the very God that you say you believe in. Amen. But we got to hold and make sure that our anchor grips the solid rock. His name is Jesus. Amen. God's beloved son. His name is Jesus. He's the only one. Be very sure. Be very sure. Amen. And we give him praise today. Amen. There was a word from the Lord coming from, amen, a few verses in the 12th chapter of Ecclesiastes and, amen, Romans 12, 1 and 2. Ecclesiastes, the 12th chapter, the 13th to the 14th verses that we're going to read, and then we're going to jump to, amen, Romans 12, 1 and 2, and we're going to take our text. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. And the word of the Lord reads in Ecclesiastes 12, 13 through 14. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing. Hidden things. Things that nobody knows but you and God. Amen. There's nothing hidden from the sight of God. Amen. And that's why it's so important to make sure we get our hearts pure. Amen. Mortify the deeds of the flesh. Separate yourself from the things of the world. Because if you're a lover of the world, you are a hater of God. Amen. Glory to God. You can't love God and mammon. Amen. You're going to hate one and love the other. Glory to God. You're going to love one and despise the other. Whether it be good or whether it be evil. Let us go to Romans 12, 1 and 2. And I'm going to take my text. I beseech you therefore, brethren and sisters, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. Holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. From these four verses, I would like to give a thought today. My life has been altered. My life has been altered. Saints of God, before the very foundations of the world, God has created us for his purpose, for his good pleasure. And God allowed us, hear me, to come into this world and to experience different things. Whether heartache and pain, trials and tribulation. God allowed us to go through all this thing and get this. The most important thing he gave us was free will. Amen. God would never make us love him. God wants us to want to love him. Amen. God will never make us serve him. He wants us to want to serve him. We come from God. And he allowed us by free will to go out and experience different things and different avenues and different courses of life. Get this. So that we can find no pleasure in them, so we can return back to him. Glory to God. There's a song that said, I searched the world over, but I couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low. Can I get a witness? Still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater after the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Nobody greater. That man had a relationship. Something happened. Can I get a witness? Something happened that caused him to turn his face to Jesus. Can I get a witness? How many know that nothing in the world can satisfy you? They got a saying, the snigger says, snigger really satisfied? No, it don't. Because you eat a bit, you still be hungry. Can I help somebody?
Right.
Hallelujah. But how many know that Jesus really satisfied you? Amen. That I'm a witness that can't nobody do you like Jesus. He's a friend that sticks closer than any brother. Amen. Hallelujah. He's a mother to the motherless. He's a shelter in the time of a storm. He's a bridge of a troubled water. How many know he's proof when you're hungry? Right. Have you ever prayed for God to pay a bill and he stepped right in right on time? And you didn't know how he was going to do it, but you know that God had a blessing. That's the kind of God that we serve. Hallelujah. All these things that God in his infinite wisdom allow us to experience things and go through different trials and heartache and pain, and allowed us to, some of us did not have mothers and fathers being there, and or destroyed marriages and been hurt by church folk. He allowed it some kind of way to work together for our good. We would know God was a deliverer if we were never in bondage. We would know God as a provider if we never had a need. Can I help somebody? Sometimes we depending on folk to do stuff that only God can do. Depending on people to make you happy. Come on here, dependent, determined whether you're going to have a good day or a bad day. Listen here, I made up in my mind a long time ago to get delivered from folk. Hallelujah. Because man will lift you up today and man will let you down the same hour. Hallelujah. But when you place in the hands of the God, nobody can pull you out. Hallelujah. And he allowed us to go through these things so we can get this, so we can trust him. And realize that can't nobody be God being God. God ain't good sometimes. Sister Ruby, he's good all the time. Because God is good. And good is God. Hallelujah. And just when you think about everything that you've gone through and you think back over your life and see what God has brought you through, you realize that if it had not been for the Lord who's on my side, where would I be? I feel the Holy Ghost coming in here. I feel somebody just getting a nudge right there in your spirit. God want to remind you that I'm still God. Hallelujah. I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I'm not changing. I'm just trying to get you to exercise your faith. I'm just trying to get you to believe in me. What makes it hard for us, Elder Salt, is that we try to make our own way for us. But how many know that God has predestined us to come into the knowledge or to come into the image or the likeness of Christ? Do you hear me? He allowed you to go through that hurt, get this, so you won't hurt nobody else. He allowed you to be talked about so you stop talking about other folk. Ain't it something how we dish it, but we can't take it? Hallelujah. We get mad at everybody else, but we don't want nobody to get mad at us. Y'all better help me in the house. The name of my life has been altered. The things I used to do, I don't do no more. The places I used to go, can I get a witness? I used to come to church, Mother Vanessa, but now I done stepped in, I'm gonna come to church. I had church wherever I'm at, in my car, in the washer, in the washroom, in the shower, in the bathroom. On my job, I'm having church. Why? Because I got the Spirit of the Lord on the inside of me.
That's right.
Hear me. Jesus. Amen. Man, I feel the Holy Ghost. And all that He's done for me. I go to church. I go to church. When get this, when the bills are due and you don't know where the money coming from. Say, neighbor, stop tripping and go to church. Hallelujah. And the kids are acting up and everything seems to be going in disarray. Can't they just go to church? What are you saying? You can stop right where you are and begin to praise God. Because God inhabit the praises of His people. Say, neighbor, if you just keep on messing up on me, I'm going to keep on lifting my hands and praising God. Because when God comes in a situation, the devil gotta flee. Say, neighbor, you better watch out. Hallelujah, God is raising up in me. Say, greater is preparing me for greater. Greater is giving for something better. This life, when this life has passed, I'm going to the place. Hallelujah. Say, soon and very soon, I'm going up yonder, up and away. I feel like Superman, up and away. I don't have to run in my hallelujah, in my telephone booth, but I got a prayer closet that causes me to go up and away. When trials of life seem to bear down, I can say, Father, I stretch my hand to Thee. No other help by anybody in here that made up in your mind. Anything can happen. Why? Because my life has been altered.
Hallelujah.
Y'all hear me?
Hallelujah.
This is an altar. Where sacrifices are made.
Yeah.
Unto God. And when you offer yourself up, you become a sacrifice. Hear me? And when you offer yourself up, hear me? Your life will be altered. Y'all hear me? Be changed.
Yes, God.
Hear me? Because the reason why we're so frustrated is because we haven't altered our lives.
Amen.
We keep trying to do it ourselves. We bring it to God and we take it back. Lord, my children need this salvation. Then when they start acting up, you get mad and frustrated. But don't you know that because you prayed for their deliverance, the devil going to act up?
All right.
That's when you know that God is at
work. Yeah.
That means, you know, when you see the enemy start acting a fool, that means God is disturbing the enemy. See, one thing, we get all bothered in it. Because we're going by what we see. Tell your neighbor, don't walk by what you see. But walk by faith. For God is spirit and they that worship Him. Let's worship Him in spirit and in truth. And so I'm not, come on here, going to listen to what the devil is saying. But I got a word in my spirit. Can I give you a revelation? And that's why God will give us a word. And when we hear the word, we step out on faith. And David said like this, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Surely goodness and mercy, they're pushing me into purpose. They're pushing me to be better. They're pushing me to do better. They're pushing me to trust God. And get this, because I step out in faith on the word of God. The word is behind me. But as I keep walking in the journey of God, and the Bible says, and it came to pass, the word of God will come past you. The word of God will get in front of you and manifest. But understand this, your faith is no longer there. Your faith is never where. Your faith is always ahead of you and moving on to something else. So neighbor, I believe God got greater for me. But in a moment, in a twinkle of an eye, when the last trumpet sound, I'm going to be caught up. The Bible said the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we that remain shall be caught up. Pray and catch up with me. Catch up. You've been playing church long time. Catch up. Come on, rise up and be who God called you to be. Come on and pray like they never put it before. Come on and fast like they never fast before. I don't know about y'all, but I feel my change coming. Oh, I feel in a moment I'm going to take off corruption and put on clear incorruption. Mortality, gonna put on immortality. I'm gonna be with Him forever to give Him praise, forever to give Him glory. I don't have time to play with the devil. I don't have time to play with soul salvation. There's
people dying on the way to hell. Can I preach in here? But not on my watch. Because Lord, whatever you need me to do, if you want me to be a doormat, walk on me. Come on. If you need me to be a doorkeeper, I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of the Lord than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. Say, neighbor, find your praise in the living God. When your life has been altered, you don't live for yourself. And I'm preaching here, your sacrifice, your life, come on here, is designed to bring glory to the living God. My Lord, let me be a witness. If I can't preach like Paul, I testify like Peter. Can I preach in the house? God has given every last one of us a weapon to use. Stop comparing yourself with everybody else and say, Lord, here am I. Use me.
Conclusion, the closing. Yes, the matter. Our duty is to fear God and to keep His commandments. We have lost the fear of God.
All right.
We don't respect God like we say we do. We come to church when we want, how we want. Then we get mad, we sit down, we stop. Y'all can't kind of help somebody in the house. Get this. Because when you truly in touch with God, when people do you wrong, the Lord said, take it.
That's right.
The Lord said, take it. When people lie on you, talk about it, God said, take it. Hallelujah. You want to feel sorry for yourself? God said, this is where I got you.
All right.
Just stay right where you are. Be encouraged. Trying to help somebody.
All right.
I know none of y'all have ever been talked about. I know everybody's always patted you on your back. Everybody has been your friend. Can I help? You all never right. Had friends that stab you in your back. Come on here. Smiling in your face.
Backstabbers.
Yes. All right. Yes.
Come on.
Yes, Lord.
And then to get this. You over there crying in the woman, God steady shaking his head and said, won't you trust me? I'm doing something that they can't understand. Can I give you a revelation? You know what messes us up? It's because we too nosy.
All right.
Lift your hand.
Amen.
Too nosy. Everybody hear me what I'm going to say? In the earth realm, they have what they call spies or double agents. Mm-hmm. And they reveal information, get this, in bits and pieces. They give them assignment. But sometimes they don't fully understand the assignment until they really get in there. Because just in case if they're captured, they won't be tortured. Get this, they won't reveal all of the plan. Y'all hear me? So that's why God gives us bits and pieces, get this, on a need-to-know basis. That's why the Bible said, for we know in part and we prophesy in part. Y'all hear me? Because get this. Because God don't want you to try to do it yourself.
That's right.
If you know everything, you try to do it yourself.
That's right.
You know everything, you already know everything, how it's going to work, you try to cut corners. You know how to do it.
That's right.
Get that man and put it together. Oh, I don't have to put this treasure. I know how to do it and figure it out. You finally see that one piece that's not in there and realize, I be doggone. I gotta take this whole thing apart because it's not functioning properly. Y'all better, I should have read the instructions.
All right.
And if you, sometimes you gotta go back to the drawing board and start over. Can I help somebody? And that's what it is with many of us. Because we're trying to do it ourselves instead of following the instruction of the word of God.
All right.
Hallelujah. We're trying to do it. Got it all together. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I haven't made it to heaven yet, but my life has been altered. Hallelujah.
Right.
I'm living each and every day.
Apostle
Paul said it like this, for I am crucified with Christ, but nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. And the life that I now live, I don't live for myself, but I live for the glory of God the Father. Can I help somebody in here? Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, God wants less. He wants to see less of us and more of him. Can I help somebody in the house? Gotta die to yourself, to your selfish ways, to your way of thinking, to your attitude, and say, Lord, not my will, but thy will be done. Another thing, understand this about a living sacrifice. A living sacrifice has a tendency when it's placed on the altar. The Apostle Paul said this. He said,
He said, brother, that he is present your bodies a living sacrifice. Stop looking for God to do something for you that God has called you to do for yourself. God ain't gonna take your body. You gotta give it to him. Y'all better help me now. You gotta offer yourself up. You can't say, Lord, make me do what you want me to do. No, he don't do that. He said, whosoever will, let him come. Come on here. Jesus said, not my will, but thy will be done. You gotta surrender yourself. Tell your neighbor, come under the covering. When you surrender means give way to him. And that's what God wants us to do. He wants us to yield ourselves to him. God is not looking for a vessel of silver and gold. He's looking for a yielded vessel. Say, neighbor, God is looking for somebody that will yield himself to him.
Right, yeah.
I made a lot of mistakes, but can I help somebody? God takes the misfits. God takes the most outcast people. God makes he takes the most unlikely to succeed. And then he cleans them up. Can I help somebody? I'm one of them. I'm one of those X-Men. I used to be, but I'm not no more. But can I get a witness in the house? Used to lie, steal, and cheat, but I ain't no more. Can I get a witness in the house? Used to drink, used to party, used to club, but I ain't one of them no more. Why? Because I'm a blood bond. I'm a spirit filled. A tongue talking. Can I help somebody in the house? I'm not ashamed of my God, because my God is good. And because when he saved me, when I'm in fit to be saved, I don't know about y'all, but God is calling you back. No matter what you've been bound by, no matter what you call a pin, God loves you for who you are. But he want to heal your broken spirit. He want to heal your broken soul. Can I help somebody in the house? I'm a witness that my life has been altered. I got the Holy Ghost on the inside. Anybody got the power of God? Hallelujah. That you love the other people that lied on you, that talked about you, that said you were going to be nothing. And that was the best thing that ever happened, because you realize there was a power on the inside of you that they were provoking to come up and come out. They gave up on you. But look at you, you still here. They threw me away, but look at you, you still standing. They good for you to die, but you still living. Can I get a witness in the house? They ain't over to God.
Yeah.
Anybody got to carry you?
That's right.
Lord, but I'm dirty. Come as you are.
Yeah.
Lord, but I did this. I know I can make that. Come on.
Right.
Lord, but who's looking at me? Are you allowing me to stop you in salvation because you're ashamed of your pride? Y'all better help me in the house. Did they die for you? No, they didn't.
No.
Come on. We care so much about what people think instead of what God thinks.
Amen.
Y'all better help me in the house.
Amen.
Because get this. God thinks greater for us than we even think for ourselves.
Amen.
Help me in the house.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. You saying, I can't make it. He said, yes, you can. You said, Lord, I can't take it. He said, yes, you can. Hallelujah. Why? Because he knows what he put in you.
Right.
Don't look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, God knows what he put in you.
I know what he put in you.
No, but it's so much of it. I don't know what I'm going to do. Yes, you do. Trust me. I never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. This service today is a transformational service. And I feel people just I feel people being convicted right now. Come on, lift your hands. God said, give me your broken dreams. Give me your letdowns.
Yes, Lord.
Give me your past failures and past mistakes. Give them to me.
Thank you, God.
Why did the enemy do that? Because he knew that God had purpose on your life.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everybody hear me? You may not be called to preach behind the pulpit, but God has called us all to proclaim the gospel.
Yes.
Give it to your employees. Making dirty jokes and you laughing and cracking up. You know you're losing your witness.
That's right.
Yep. If you're going to be in the midst, be alive. Y'all help me.
Yeah.
Be alive. Jesus, he ate with publicans and sinners.
Yeah.
And they said, oh, look at him. He's a drunkard. Get this. He
He wasn't there for fellowship. He was there for salvation.
All right.
He was there to be a witness.
Come on.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
Everybody hear me? Apostle Paul said that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice. Your mind, your heart, your soul. Because a lot of people just have lip service but don't have no heart service.
Amen.
They say they love God, but they don't love God because it's not in the heart. They come to church because mommy and daddy told them to say, come out of church, say, just to ease your mind. But what's that? See, everything, everybody hear me, is that so many people come to a physical church, but they still will bust hell gates wide open because they never gave their lives to Christ.
Amen.
Because they chose to be, sin separates us from God.
Amen.
Everybody hear me? Sin separates us from God. When we practice in sin and living in sin, we're separated from God. Until we truly cry out from our heart, saying, God, help me, deliver me. That's when God comes to bring deliverance. And when he does, when he comes, do this, you got to depend on him. You got to trust him. And you just can't come to church and expect the preacher to lay hands on you.
Amen.
Your breakthrough. Can I help somebody?
Amen.
Your greatest breakthrough is going to come with your personal time. Offering yourself up to God.
Amen.
In prayer. Worship. Fasting. Come on, study the word of God.
Amen.
Which brings about a revelation of God. It brings about a foundation in God so you can trust God and walk in him. Hallelujah. And I realize this. Everybody hear me. I can't live right by myself.
Amen.
I have to trust, get this, in the leading of the Holy Spirit in me to be in God.
Amen.
Y'all hear me? And that's why I did this. He promises when there's things that he wants us not to do, telling us, nah, don't do that. Don't do that. And we dumb it down. We resist it. Or the Bible calls it quenching the Spirit. Get this. The Spirit of God will not always strive with man. You can get to the point where you keep on preaching the Spirit, will hear the point.
He sure will.
And the Bible, the Scripture says, he said, it is impossible for someone who has tasted of this good thing, get this, to receive it. Once it gets this, to play this, to receive it. Whoa, y'all hear me? Y'all hear me? Everybody understand this. Now I want to get this out the way. God has never made somebody or predestined people for hell. Let's get an understanding. It's our choice to reject God that sends us to hell.
Amen.
He don't say, I'm going to make this one right here for heaven and make this one for heaven. He don't do it. Everybody understand this? Even when he talks about the pot, he sent Jeremiah down there. Jeremiah go to the potter's house. Jeremiah go down. And the potter was making this little clay. Get this. But then something happened with the clay. It was marked. Y'all get me? It wasn't the potter. It was the clay that had the issue. Y'all hear me? So what he had to do, he had to make it into a lesser a vessel. It wasn't as valuable or as glorious as the former that he intended.
All right.
Everybody hear me?
Yes.
Just like Pharaoh. Pharaoh was not going to be sentenced to hell. But get this. By the time when God sent Moses, his mind was already sealed.
Yes.
God had given Pharaoh many chances.
Yes.
Y'all help me.
Yes.
I need somebody to help me.
That's true.
And that's why God told Moses. He said, Moses, go. And he said, he's not going to do it. He said, I'm going to bring this plate. It's going to harden his heart. I'm going to bring this plate. It's going to harden his heart. I'm going to bring this plate. It's going to harden his heart. But I'm going to do this last one. He's going to let you go. He's going to let the people go. Hear me. Forget this. His heart was still hardened because even after he let the people go, he wanted to go after them.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Falling to the Red Sea.
Yes.
Both of them panicking, tripping. People panicking. And God said, stretch out the body. Y'all hear me? May not have a dollar, but I got a rug.
That's right.
Y'all better hear me.
Yes.
May not have a new house, but I got a rug. I got an anointing. Y'all better hear me. Whatever God has placed in your hand, you can use it.
Amen.
Now everybody hear me. Go over to God. Go ahead. Now hear me. Can I go spiritually with y'all? I'm going to go take a little deeper. He said, in your hand is not only talking about in your
the words, I got word of life in my mouth that I can speak life to dead things. Hallelujah.
Right.
Come on here. Here, Collector said, you're going to lose it. The devil is a liar. My God shall supply all my needs. Come on here. You got to remind, you got to remind God who he is.
It's for people to be in church, but they don't give themselves to God because they think they can outwit or outsmart God.
All right.
You deceive yourself.
Amen.
Get this. Because God, he is so merciful that even when people rebel and sin against him, he gives them warning after warning. Warning after warning.
Amen.
To get their lives in order.
Amen.
Everybody hear me. Hear me what he said. I'm not concerned about anything but God.
Amen.
I'm concerned about souls being saved. Hear me. Now everybody hear me. It's okay to make plans for the future. But if you don't have plans for heaven,
they know them.
Stuff that's going to happen in the next week that's going to shake the whole world. The Lord's giving you visions and dreams. Calamity coming up all over the world. Like never before. I'm not here to scare you. I'm here to warn you to get your house in order. Glory to God. Amen. The Lord told me to tell him. He said, tell them. Calling them to come unto me. I'm calling them to come closer. Tell them to forsake the things of the world and turn to me with their whole hearts. Get this. Because anything you give more attention to than God is your God.
Amen.
Come on. I'm not here to offend nobody. I'm here to offend the devil.
Amen.
Your soul means more to me than anything.
Yes, man.
We put our trust in what we have and what we do, but only what we do for Christ will last.
Yeah.
And that's what counts more than anything. I think about some of the dreams that some of the members have shared with me, and everybody hear me. The rapture is at hand.
Yeah.
Y'all hear me?
Yeah.
It can happen this week. It can happen today. It's at hand.
Yeah.
There's things happening now that wasn't happening. There's a verse that talks about in Luke 21, someone go to Luke 21, 21st chapter. Luke 21. I'm going to share with y'all how close we really are. And it says this, and when ye shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies, then ye know that the desolation thereof is nigh. Everybody hear me. Jerusalem, Israel, is already encompassed. That's why you have all these armies. Russia, China, get this, Saudi Arabia, Iran, come on here, U.S., already in Syria, and NATO forces in Syria. But you also got the Mediterranean Sea that you have also navies out there. They're surrounding. Why? Something major is about to happen. Everybody, let's wake up. Something major is about to happen. And God is calling us to open our eyes and to cry out to him. Why?
because his coming is very nigh.
Yeah.
Hear me. He said, the rapture is at hand.
Yes, it is.
If you go to bed and wake up and your children gone, there's going to be utmost panic. I mean, people running out, people going to be losing their mind, people going to be committing suicide because they're going to realize he warned us about it. But we've been so caught up in the world, I didn't think that they've been saying it for years.
Mm-hmm.
See? That's what they've been talking about. The Lord's coming, man, ain't. Don't be caught off guard.
Right.
Let me finish reading this. Now, I'm for the close, but let me finish reading it. It said, then let them which are in Judea flee to the mountains, and let them which are in the midst of it depart out, and let not them that are in the countries enter thereinto. For these be the days of vengeance. Get this, vengeance for what? The wrath of God.
Mm-hmm.
The wrath of God is upon the earth. Why is God raining down wrath? It's because man have turned their face from God. And God is calling us. He's being merciful. He let us get our house in order. Now I'm going to share this with you. The Lord said this to me. He said, there's going to be one major event that's going to happen before the rapture. And that's going to be the last moment for people to really cry out. It's not the time for people just saying, don't be superficial. It got to be hard. God is going to look at the hearts of men. Come on. So people know. That's why everybody here, you got to be in position to witness to any and everybody. You can't say,
right,
I'm just going to witness to this class, uh-huh, and forget about them. You got to be available to witness to any and everybody at
that's
any
right
and every time.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the moment you caught up in a weakness, you miss an opportunity.
Yes.
Now hear me. Because there's a soul, there's souls that need to be saved.
That's right.
And if your life is altered, can I help somebody? You don't belong to yourself.
Yeah.
A sacrifice, a sacrifice is not given for itself. It's given for someone else.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on here. And that's why God wants you to lay down your life. Hallelujah. When you alter yourself on the altar of God, you are laying down your own life. Come on here, and you picking up the life of Christ to be a witness to the lost world.
Amen.
Why is it so hard for us to do what God calls us to do? Get this, because the enemy, first of all, don't want you to do it.
Amen.
And first of all, and second of all, we've been taught that it don't take all that, isn't it? And we got to break that old mindset. Tell you, if I'm breaking those chains of tradition of my mind right now. It don't take all that to have church. That's why you're still in bondage. Y'all better help me. When you really want salvation and deliverance, you do whatever you have to do to get it. You leave. Come on here. God told Abraham, get out of your own country. Leave your kinfolk. Come on here. I'm sending you to a place. Why? Because I got something greater for you to do. You can't deliver them because they in bondage. But I'm going to deliver you out of bondage because I got nations on, come on the inside of you. Everybody listen to me. There's souls waiting to be saved that's on the inside of you. That God has given you a word to be saved. Can I help somebody? And when you don't be who God has called you to be, don't you know that souls are lost? Everybody hear me. Thank you, Holy Ghost. The mystery of the seed. The seed don't die, it can't reproduce.
Uh-huh.
If you don't die to self, you can't produce. That's why Jesus said, if any man come after me, let him deny, die to yourself. Take up his cross and follow me. That's why he don't want you to forgive the other person. That's why when somebody tells you off, he wants you to tell them off. Because it takes your witness. Get this. Because when it takes your witness, get this, death is dead in your mind. And that's why when you repent, it brings back life. Y'all better help me. It brings back life. Come on here. Come on here, come on here, come on here, come on here. Speak good things. I dare you. Speak blessings over your neighbor. Speak favor over your neighbor. I'm almost done. He said, all these things which are written may be fulfilled. But woe unto them that are with child, to them that give stuff in those days, for there shall be great distress in the land and wrath upon this people. Now everybody hear me. He's not only talking about Israel. Talking about the world.
Amen.
The world is crying out. That's why these earthquakes is the groaning and the moaning of the world. Birth pains. great distress in the earth.
Amen.
Can I help you? I've been giving this revelation about volcanoes. Wherever there are volcanoes are where they have the most, get this, human sacrifices.
Amen.
Volcanoes that eruption the whole, the lava, those are doorways to hell. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
This stuff is real. Even in World War II, when the Germans were drilling down, they drilled down so far that they could hear voices. And they drilled down so far, they put this man who was a prisoner in a basket down so far. And they heard the cries and screams, and they pulled him back up. This man was pale white and his hair was solid. Because he saw something that wasn't normal to the human eye.
Amen.
Come on, lift your hands. When you leave this place today, I want you to make sure, Lord, I give you my heart, my mind, my soul. And I'm not playing no more. Get this. Because every opportunity you have to get it right, you dismiss it, you're going to remember. You're going to be tormented by it down in hell. There's preachers preaching down there, preaching hard, preaching up a storm. But it's too late. Come on, lift your hands. Let me jump down. Let me jump down and say this. Get this. 24th verse. It said, 24th verse. And they shall fall by the edge of a sword and shall lead away captive into all nations. Be led away captive in all nations. And Jerusalem shall be trodden down to the of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. What is talking about the times of the Gentiles be filled? Talking about the 7 years.
Amen.
The seven, the great tribulation period. That's what he's talking about. Glory to God. Now it says, verse 25 here, and there shall be signs in the sun. Don't you see stuff happening in the earth realm? Don't you see signs in the sky?
Amen.
Get this. And in the moon, and in the stars, and upon the earth, the stress of nations. Get this. That's why we have so many countries, economy collapsing right now. It's because of the stress of the nations. You have all these different riots, you have these states. Some of these states have already issued martial law. Why? Because they're calling police states now. Because they want to enforce, how can I say this? The elite is what they call it. Believe in causing order out of chaos. Y'all hear me? Terrorism is not a person, it's a spirit. And the only way terrorism can be combated is through faith and prayer. Y'all hear me? And that's why we as a church have to do our part to pray. And that's why when we come together, we don't come together to socialize. We come together to work.
That's right.
We come together in the seed.
Amen.
We come together. It's work, it's labor.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God. And so, hear me. I make the request again. If you can come, please come. If you came because of job, we understand. But I'm telling you, it's life changing. It's life changing.
Right.
When you come and get in the presence of God and you can cry out,
yes.
You feel that peace, you feel like, oh my
Hallelujah.
God, something lifted off of me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To change your life.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yeah, let me say this. Let me say this. Get this. It said, the stress of the nation. Get this, with perplexity. And the sea and the waves roaring. What is it talking about? Hurricanes and tsunamis. Earthquakes under the earth. Can I help somebody under the sea? That's what's taking place already. And God said, if you don't believe it, just look around and see.
All right.
But what's so scary is that we're seeing the signs, but we're not listening.
Lord, help us in the house.
Because we believe it, it ain't going to happen to me. Everybody else, it ain't going to happen in the United States. Hear me? God's judgment is up on the U.S. You know, God bless America. God done bless America, but America has spit in God's face.
That's right.
Homosexuality?
Yeah.
Hear me.
Amen.
A president that endorses it, the devil is a liar.
Amen.
Oh, you gotta marry. No, I don't.
No.
You just gonna put me in prison, do whatever you wanna do. I got why? Because I believe
That's
the word
right.
of God.
Amen.
Now hear me. We don't tear people down because of, come on here. We pray for them because sin is a sin.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Amen.
Can I have 10 minutes? I'll be done. What is it that you don't want to give up? What is it that's stopping you from coming up and giving yourself totally to God?
Yes.
not make it another day.
Amen.
And you got preachers being killed in the pulpit. One was shot by his own brother.
Mm-hmm.
We're living in perilous times. Come on. And that's why we should never take for granted one moment each other. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I appreciate you.
I appreciate you.
I appreciate you. And if I've offended you in any way, please forgive me. I've already forgiven you, so there's no problem. I love you. Come on, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. See, because if we don't get together down here, you can't expect to get together up there.
All right. That's right.
They got a place for brawlers. They got to brawl in.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
They got to fight each other.
Yeah.
Right now. Come on, lift your hands. I'm almost done.
Amen.
26 verse says, men's hearts shall fail in them for the fear, for fear. Give his sense of God. Hear me, hear me. You can't imagine. Your worst nightmare is nothing compared to what's going to come from the face of God.
Amen.
Hear me. If I be a man of God, I lie not in this pulpit. I lie not in the Holy Ghost. In the next week, you're going to see something that you don't realize that your family was telling the truth. Some things I cannot reveal to y'all. Because people won't believe. Because their mind can't conceive it.
Amen.
Even when the Lord showed me, I will. I cried out for mercy. America was worse than a third world country.
Yeah.
Don't think that these people talking about these nuclear, this and that, they just gonna play games. It's gonna happen. Y'all hear me? New York, I saw New York wiped out. Millions and millions of people, everybody hear me, headed to hell. And I'm going to do my best for praying in the seat for the mercy of God, for God to save me. Everybody hear me. You can't tell me that you saved and you don't have a compassion for souls.
Oh, yes, God. Thank you, Lord.
You can't tell me that you full of the Holy Ghost and you don't have a love to get out and witness to somebody.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, lift your hands.
Amen.
And let me get back over here. He asked us to present our bodies as living sacrifices.
Yes.
Get this, which is not a one-time thing. It has to be a continuing thing. Giving ourselves. Because a living sacrifice has a tendency of falling and leaving the altar. Come on. That's why. Get this. Prayer keeps us on the altar. Prayer keeps us in the presence. Prayer keeps us in the will of God. Fasting. Come on here. Cause you to die to yourself. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is what God is calling for. Glory to God. For us to truly fast and seek his face. Glory to God. Why? Because there's people that need what you got. There's people that need you to be who God has called you to be. Come on. There's people that need you to pray. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Intercede for them. No matter what they've done to you, even your enemy, pray and ask God to deliver them and to heal them and that his love will convert them. Glory to God. And you forgive them. Let God have them. Come on. Glory to God. Now, he says the second thing. And be not conformed to the things of this world. Get out of this world. Get out of the mindset of this world. Get this. The more you are engulfed in the world, the more you become like the world. The more you act like the world. The more you think like the world. If you think like the world, you have worldly results.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on. Amen. That's why everything, the media, clothing, wants you to, come on, go get that new suit.
Amen.
It ain't doing nothing for witnessing. It's just doing something for your flesh.
Uh-huh.
Y'all!
Right.
Yes.
Amen.
You know what I did? I had my wife and said, you need a haircut? She said, something to deny myself. Why? Because getting a haircut benefits me.
Uh-huh.
Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Okay.
I know I probably need one. But we need to get to the place where if God says, don't do it, I'm not going to do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Man, that's the sale going on. I might as well get that. Are you getting it for you or are you getting it for someone else?
Amen.
Because see, the more we feed into the world system, the more we feed the flesh. God was saying, son, don't eat a piece of cake. Lord, you know, I sure won't see. Get this, and then you go ahead and eat it anyway, then you be sick of the dog. Lord, I should have done. Father, forgive me.
Amen.
I said, we're going to stop moving on.